Hi, this is Terry Sprouse. Today I'm going to talk about 5 steps to prepare your house, get it ready for tenants. And I'm going to recommend a few books you can use that will help you in the process. And I know you're thinking, what? Books? Everything's already on YouTube that I need to know. Well, that's not quite true. And there's still a place in this world for books. So, step one, clear everything out of your house. Get out the furniture, food, toys, children, dogs and cats. Get everything out so you have plenty of room and space to do the cleanup and the repair work. Not only does it give you space to work, but also it has the advantage of when tenants come to look at the property, they can see a spacey, roomy area instead of a cluttered house. And they can imagine their own sofas and beds in there more easily than they could if your house was all cluttered up. Step two, start repairing and getting the house ready. So this includes making sure everything works, everything's painted that moves, that doesn't move. And so you don't want any drippy faucets, you want to fix leaky toilets, you want to make sure doors open and close, fix any leaky roofs, the whole 9 yards. If you don't do a thorough job of this, I promise that some evening after you've rented the property or some weekend, you'll get a call when you least want one from a tenant to say they've got a leaky faucet or their toilet's not flushing. So do your best early on, right off the bat, to get everything working. And how, you ask? How can I do these projects if I don't know anything about toilets or electricity or anything like that? Well, the answer is these 4 books I'm going to recommend to you right now. Number one is Time Life Complete Fix-It-Yourself Manual. This is the first fix-it book I ever bought. It's aimed at repairing larger appliances. It takes you through step by step and is a great book that will help you repair a lot of appliances. Reader's Digest Fix-It-Yourself Manual. This covers more ground, another great reference book you should have on hand, which I use constantly. And the next two are examples of books from Home Depot, but other stores too, like Lowe's, produce these kind of series of books on repairing things. Here's one called Wiring 123, which will address many of the types of projects that you will need to use in your house. Same with this one, Plumbing 123. It teaches you how to do simple plumbing things like replacing toilets and almost everything you need to know. And as I said, there's a series. There's one on flooring, one's on painting. Whatever you need to know, there it is. And another suggestion is, if you have to replace things like doors or appliances usually, don't buy new stuff, you know. Go to stores like the Habitat for Humanity store, which recycles used building materials, and get things at 1/10 the cost you'd pay at a big box store. And not only is this good for you, but your pocketbook, but these things last as well as a new one would. And you know that once the tenants move in, all your things are going to take a pounding anyway, so it doesn't have to look new, it just has to look good and work good. Step three, in some cases, even with these great books I recommended, you will not be able to quickly and efficiently repair a large appliance, such as a washing machine, a dryer, or a refrigerator. In that case, I recommend going to a good used appliance store that refurbishes appliances. And I go to one here that gives me a 6-month guarantee, and they come in, deliver the appliance, and take out the old one. So that's the way to go. You get it cheaper than new, and all the appliances I've bought there have worked the entire 10 years that I've been in this business, and so they're fairly reliable. Step four. What's the first thing people look at when they see your house? The outside, of course. So step four is to get the outside of your house looking nice. Make sure it's painted. Make sure the yard looks nice. And I'm not saying to put a lot of plants or flowers in there that will require water and work. In fact, I really suggest that you do a low maintenance yard so that there's less work to do by the tenant, and it saves you a lot of work later on when you come back to repair the house between tenants. So make a nice looking front yard. You can put pots of flowers on the yard, on the sidewalk or around that you can remove later after the place is rented out. Step number five, and at the end of this video, I'm going to show you an example of a low maintenance yard that I think is a good example. Step five, take photographs of your property, the different rooms, different appliances, after you've got it all in ship shape. This way, if there was any arguments at the end of a tenant's lease, you can whip out the photos and say, hey, you know, this is what it used to look like. This does not preclude the fact of having them still fill out a form, you know, the checkoff list that you hand to them when they sign the papers, and you go around with them and, you know, visually verify that everything's in good shape, and they check off and sign it, and you sign it too. Those things go hand in hand. So there you have it. Follow my five steps, get these four books, and you'll be well on the way to a successful rental business. My next video, or one of my next ones, will be how to attract tenants to your property like elephants to peanut butter. So here's an example of what I consider a low maintenance yard. There's rocks covering most of the yard, plants that don't require very much water. There's plastic underneath the rocks. You can see over here there's a drain from the roof that runs down into a little canal covered by rocks with rocks in it, and the water runs from the canal straight to the tree.